okay, so here's Uhura and Uncle Alfred, and they both have really cool computers with loads of flashing lights. And I always loved that kind of thing, and so I wanted to have something like that in my robot life set for Vincent to control. So I made some sketches and stuff. And I found these old DDR TVs, and with a bit of research, I figured out how to control the electron beam. If you don't know how old TVs work, there's basically two electromagnets, one which controls up and down, and one which controls left and right. And then there's an electron gun, which just fires an electron beam through the magnets, which basically pull this electron, they steer it through this space, either up and down or left and right. If you find the wires that control those electromagnets, then you can use any electrical signal to steer the electron beam. It's pretty cool. Very beautiful when you play a synth through it, because it's a very pure sound and you get really nice shapes. Almost like a three-dimensional. Then I started building the case, so I basically cut it all out of birch ply, like I make everything out of birch ply. And lots of fiddling, screwing, that sort of stuff. It started to come together. Flipped it over, did the other side, more screwing. I just have this tiny little area in the entrance hall of my studio where I do all my building stuff like that. It gets a bit cramped. Fitting the front panel, which I cut slightly too tight, but anyway, I think I shaved it off a little in the end. And so here's the little platform for the two TVs to sit on at the back. There we go. All looking good. All fitting nicely. Very good. Cutting a little thing here for the back. Alright, then painting the front panel with some dull military grade grey paint that I had lying around. Some cool lens flare on the camera there. And then I had some fantastic gold glitter paint left over from this fairy tale dressing mirror that I made at Christmas. It's really great stuff, this glitter paint. I had an old keyboard, which I sprayed pink, and there was the case pretty much done. Then I had to make all of the flashing buttons. So I got these ice cube trays, and I poured some resin into them to make these opaque white buttons. I got Vincent involved sanding the backs flush, because there was a little ridge. And then I drilled a hole, not all the way through, but just into the back of each button. Just exactly the right size for an LED to fit into. Vincent tested the LEDs. And then I glued them in. I think we had six different coloured LEDs. And I divided them up into four banks, which could be each switched on or off together. So it could all be synced up with the music and stuff in time. But then on the back, I had to solder all the banks together, which was quite a bit of work, but not too bad. As you can see here, everything's numbered with a little resistor on each one as well. Thank you. made some dummy knobs and put some coloured LEDs inside the VU meters, all looking pretty glitzy. And then round the back, the computer hides inside, connected to this Dada machine's MIDI controller thing, which you send MIDI into it and it sends out 24 volts over 12 channels, so I could control all the flashing lights, and I could also control a couple of robot drumsticks to play the drums, which I also put lights in. Each of the drums has a solenoid mounted onto it with a drumstick, which is controlled by the computer, and then everything's controlled by this keyboard. So this is it.